นานาควาบะ
ยาเอซอง
เอฟ้าชวนน้ำพุ่มสุ
ดมาดามาอยู่ห้
องอุ้งสิสิเสดี
อุ้งเสนาจ่าในจีมาย
ังคุ้มฟ้ามาเดียชินเดียเนสันนิจิงความวัดดารุโมเอเยคัสเซอัสซันติพาร์ติพเอติงกรุ๊ปะเอเยฮวยมโนโน
Well, where Asante Confederacy? Just a mra, ye bachi, yura, na prempe, a course of shares. These are the group standing behind advocating, so Babak, not by war. These are the people.
Okay. Matia say, na enaye nyina e be share our regional house of chiefs, a war Asante. Na ne butaye nti edi be hie ha no conference na ye ye ne butaye no wada roma
well I'm going may be can from my own view.
That's okay.
Because as a press conference there definitely there has been a press statement amogina so I release no but may be can the way I see the whole things. Okay. All right, and as a media personnel like you people no I wish sir you may take my advice. All right, and maybe you may consult later on. What I'm saying is this. Normally, if you check YouTube and other media transmissions, there are some certain words we don't use.
Okay.
I hope you're going to take me serious on this. There are some certain things we don't use, which even like YouTube and other medias, right? When you use some words, either it's omitted or they even block you.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't see why. Because maybe it's spoken in our language. Because this, some of these people who are talking all this against Yura Asante Hene, they use tree language. So maybe the tree language is not being censored through the media or the YouTube. So enough time, some of these insultive and abusive words now is still maintained, which don't supposed to be so. So you, the media people, I want you people to take note of that. I think because of our language, you people are not checking that, or the media or the YouTube, they are not checking that. And you should go there very seriously. Because in the media this time around, not all words are allowed to be used. But I don't know why most of these words are used. So I think you see the point I'm making.
Mm-hmm.
So if possible, you people should check that out if you have the means to do that. All right, so that most of these insulting words, because there's a way you can deliver a message. If you see that something is not going right, you have to say it's not going right. If you want to advise, you have some innovative mind, you want to say something to the people, to the community, you can say it instead of using insulting words, which is not right. Okay, so since now we're all trying to be polite, internationally we're trying to be polite, that is why most of these words are censored. So why don't we try to censor our tree language into those things so that people don't use some words which is not supposed to be used, all right? Not to extend to our king,
okay.
You know?
Yeah, of course, our king. Patro Yantu also say me, besides say, I can't say, she would be any a mu target pan and say, why am I not a person who wants to sense and who wants to come out to me?
Like, yeah, we are not a kind, yeah, and I'm not a Obi ye busu ni ana se oye busu dia ya ni time on the day, and maybe I may also don't have to say that, but most people who are on the platform now and I say most of the multimedia now, you know what we mean by some people insulting our king, and that's what it affects us so much. I understand, because like the press release tells you that the king is not a political figure.
Yeah.
If some economic delays are going on, you have to blame the king.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that one has been answered. But where I'm going is that I want to tell you people something for you to understand. What I'm saying is that if you watch most of these people, the way they talk, like one of the boys used to say, "Hey, I knew them without you, war, like, flocks are singing song behind you." Now, when you check that, it means the person himself saying that was from a remote place of either, if it's from Ghana, then a very deep remote of Ghana. Because if you are in Kumasi here, you will never hear war. If you are in Accra, you will never hear war. Or even so with the towns, you don't hear that. Most places you can hear that are omo omo ba ji pa do bi shishe some deep cottage no omo na omo ti sa sound no and to me I'm not trying to be insultive anyway but that would mean say sa sound na o kana dey o kana che say one he's really far from a remote area and remember that if somebody from a remote deep remote area and you pick him all of a sudden and take him to New York where you see all these skyscrapers he'll be mad. He'll be only busy, oh, use my place, not like that. And he'll be talking. And I think that's what happened to these people. They're really from really deep, remote area. And all of a sudden, they'll pick up to that place. And he's seeing visions. He's seeing dreams. He's just seeing something out of, you know. So that is the type of person I see. But I want to say another thing again. If you're somebody who knows America very well, like where he thinks he is and he's boosting off, go to California, go to New York. The slums are taking over the cities. If you like, Google it, you see it. The slums are taking over the cities. Go to California, it's a problem. The government, even the United States government, is not able to handle that. Go to people in the street that are living in the streets, living in the tents, living under bridges. Everywhere is taking over California. If he doesn't know, tell him. And let me tell you something. People who eat free food, because it's always thinking, oh, this is a free food, they're free this. People who are eating free foods are the people who are living in slums, who got nothing to do. And people just give them help. Okay? So I think it may be one of them. I don't know. Because
want to mention any name either.
I don't want to mention names, but I'm saying that anybody who lives in the United States, tell them about the slums problem in California, in New York. It's too much, the government cannot even take care of it. And if you like, go to Accra, come to Kumasi areas and see how people are living good. People are living good. So I think what I'm going to tell you people, I don't know your media houses, I'm making some programs. If you like, I'll give you some. Okay. I'm going to show you how people are living so good in Africa. Okay. People in the diaspora are begging God, they are begging, they are praying that they'll come to live in Africa. All right, because nowadays there's no slavery. People come here to slave you. You go and slave yourself. So if you are there now and you think that is heaven to you, it's not heaven. That place is a slummy place now. And people are praying to come here and live good. Do you understand? So what I'm trying to say is that it's opposite thing. This kind of person talking like this looks like he's picked up from a very remote place where he was hearing the sound of war of logs and stuff. Okay? But not in Kumasi, not in Accra, not in the modern Kumasi or modern Ghana, okay? All right? And the problem, if you want to talk about problem in New York, problem in California, problem in most cities in United States, slums is taking over the place. People are living without homes. And those are the people, they give them free food. All right? So I think the conception is two. Yeah. All right, yeah. Good.
You've really made your point. Thank you so very much.